Okay, I hope everybody has written the syllabus now. Okay, chapter number 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. And which chapter we are going to start? Chapter number 12, electricity. Okay, now in last year, suppose let's say this is exam pattern for, suppose let's say 10th. Sorry for that mistake has happened, that the title of the slide is given as exam pattern of class 9, but it is actually of class 10th. Okay, you had four exams, right, last year. First exam, second, third, and fourth. That is pre-midterm, midterm, post-midterm, and final examination. And you were so happy that your fourth exam was not conducted to a 9th standard, correct? But this year, in 10th standard, you'll be having 5 exams. In each exam, 25% extra syllabus will be added. Like for example, in first exam, 25% syllabus will be there. In second exam, it will be 50%. That is previous 25 plus new 25. For the third examination, previous 50% and the new 25%. So that is total 75%. And then for the fourth exam, it will be 100%. Okay? So that is also called as pre-board 1. Now understand this, students. Pre-board 1 is generally conducted in the month of December. And pre-board 2 is generally conducted in the month of January. So you have to understand that these exams, like only 5 will be conducted in a year. And pre-board 1 is going to be conducted in the month of December. Okay, now do one thing, on your paper, on the on your notebook, after that syllabus, please write down the, let's say, these exams, like how many exams are there and what kind of syllabus we have, percentage. So first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. I will give you roughly 1 minute. Please write it down, name of the exam and percentage of the syllabus. First exam 25, second exam 50, third exam 75, fourth exam 100%, fifth exam 100%. And fourth and fifth will be also be called as what kind of exams? Pre-board 1 and pre-board 2. Okay. While you are writing down, remember this. See, many students have a doubt that, sir, like what kind of timetable we should follow, like when the syllabus will be completed and what kind of schedule we should have. See, students, our exam of pre-board 1 is generally taken in the month of December. So even if you follow school timetable, like for example, for the second exam, that is midterm test, suppose let's say there are 6 lessons of science. So if you complete just even with the school timetable, your whole syllabus, still your 10th standard syllabus will be completed by the month of November itself, all the syllabus. Because school's completed, what you do is just follow the timetable of the school. That means you will still have how many months? 2.5 months to complete, because your exam will be starting in the month of March, particularly February end, but you can take it March. So even after that December, you'll be having how many months? Roughly 2 months to revise. So make sure that you are completing the syllabus according to school timetable. Okay? So pre-board will be conducted in the month of December. I hope you have written everything. Okay? Can we move? Okay, chalo. So this is the tentative date. Please write down, our first exam is going to be conducted on 9th of July. Okay, 9th of July to 17th of July. So this is a tentative date, of course, because these dates were created when? In the month of March, February, this year. So due to lockdown, these dates might change. But for now, we will consider as if our exams are going to happen on these dates itself. So please write down these dates. 9th of July to 17th of July. So that is the first pre-midterm exam. Okay, written 9th July to 17th July. On book you have to write down. You should have all the information. What kind of exams we have, syllabus, everything. Because there is no point in learning if you don't know what kind of exams are there. Okay, syllabus, everything. Okay, written pre-midterm exam 9th July to 17th July. Chalo. So for the first exam, there is 25% syllabus and there will be 3 lessons. Okay? From chemistry, each one from, suppose let's say chemistry, bio and physics. So first lesson will be from chemistry, bio lesson would be 6th and physics chapter number would be 12. So first lesson from chemistry is chemical reactions and equations. Life processes is from bio, electricity is from physics. So you need to write this down, but before that, listen to this. I will give you just short introduction, what kind of chapters these are and what are the contents of these chapters. See, chapter number one is a chemistry one. Okay, the name of the lesson is chemical reactions and equations. So this lesson is all about what kind of chemical reactions are there. That means reaction between reactants to form products. What kind of reactions are there? What kind of equations can be put? How to write down the equation? How to balance it? What are skeletal equations? Everything will be taught to you in chemistry first lesson. What they will be teaching? Types of reactions and how to balance them. So those things will be taught. Chapter number six is about life processes, biology. So life processes means they will be dealing with human body. Okay, life processes are the vital processes which are required for your everyday purpose, like your excretion, then digestion, then how, like, you know, what happens to the food when you eat, how it is digested. All those things will be taught to you in life processes. Like they'll be talking about respiration, they'll be talking about excretion, all those things. ठीक है तो खाने से लेके एंड तक दैट इज एक्सक्रीशन ऑल दे विल बी टेकिंग इन लाइफ प्रोसेसेस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर हां बट डेफिनेटली द डायग्राम्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन चैप्टर 6 लाइफ प्रोसेसेस दे आर लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट एंड दे आर डेफिनेटली आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम्स एज वेल सो यू हैव टू मेक श्योर टू थिंग्स इन लाइफ प्रोसेसेस फर्स्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट सेकंड थिंग यू आर गुड विद द डायग्राम्स इट विल रिक्वायर प्रैक्टिस फॉर बायो ठीक है फ्रॉम नाउ चैप्टर नंबर 12 दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी Now, let me tell you, students, every year, whenever I teach this topic, electricity, it's actually a very simple topic. But what problem comes or is expected is that students do not practice enough of the numericals on these lessons. And what happens is because of that thing, that without practice of numericals, this chapter becomes a nightmare for them. Now, every year, this chapter is taught as the first chapter of physics. But still, students, even in the month of December, November, they ask again the same question. Sir, how we can solve this numerical of electricity? Or what kind of concept, even conceptual questions they ask from electricity. And in which month? November, December month. So almost the syllabus is over, but still students are asking from the first chapter. So try to understand, out of all these lessons, main trouble that will be given to you will be by electricity. Second trouble will be given to you will be by chemistry. Third trouble will be given to you by bio. Now, none of these chapters is simple. You have to give 100%. Okay, for all these chapters. Now, after that, what we have is topics to study. For today, what things we are going to study, all those sub-points I have mentioned here. So, do one thing. Write down this portion first, that portion for pre-midterm exam in your notebook. We'll be having three chapters. That is chemistry, biophysics, chapter number 1, 6 and 12. Just note it down. This is the syllabus for pre-midterm exam. I'll be starting electricity and chemistry, bio, the concerned science teacher will be either starting with chemistry or with bio or with both. It depends on how he is going to start. Fine. That will be notified to you on the group. I'll be taking only physics. Okay, written the syllabus, chemistry, biophysics. Okay, this is pre-midterm exam. So three chapters are there. Okay, chalo. So we'll begin with our lesson. Chapter name is electricity. Chapter number 12, electricity. And these are the topics we'll study today. That is electricity, electric circuit, charges, current, its type, SI unit. Do not worry. These are just, terminologies of this lesson. I will explain you all these things in detail. Do not worry about this right now. चलो तो फर्स्ट थिंग यू हैव टू स्टडी इज व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी ठीक है तो स्टूडेंट्स ऑलवेज हैव द बैड हैबिट सी वी आर लिविंग इन परभनी राइट सो वी ऑलवेज हैव लोड शेडिंग तो व्हेनेवर आवर नेबर आस्क कि सपोज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज डू आर हैविंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और नॉट एट योर होम सो जनरली व्हाट दे से इज लाइट है कि नहीं ठीक है सो रिमेंबर दिस लाइट एंड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स ठीक है लाइट दैट इज फ्लो ऑफ फोटॉन्स एंड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज व्हाट Electricity is flow of electrons. ठीक है? So electricity is nothing but one form of energy. And anyway, you know what is energy? Last year only there was a lesson, work and energy. So what is energy? Capacity to do work. So electricity can also be used to do some kind of work. Now, what kind of devices we have at our home which runs on electricity? Actually, almost all the devices in our home works on electricity, including your mobile, then your fridge, TV, fan, AC, cooler. Your oven, your iron, everything is working on electricity. So we cannot imagine a modern day life without electricity. So it is one form of energy. Okay, second thing. Now we will be having one definition. Okay, what is electric circuit? Now remember this, that how we are actually completing this lesson. What I am doing is, I'll be taking every, what I can say, word to word from NCERT. So you have to understand that I won't be leaving anything from that book. So you just have to pay, like, you know, proper attention, and I will take all those things, okay, from the book itself. So we are completing word by word. All my lectures will be word by word from NCERT, so that I'm reducing your effort actually. Teachers are not actually supposed to take word by word, but I'm taking it for you so that you will have little, what I can say, problem in completing these lessons. So chalo, what is electric circuit? So electricity, to dekhi, what is electricity? Flow of, sorry, what is electricity? It's one form of energy. And we have to see second definition now. What is electric circuit? Circuit kya hota? Jaise ki, for example, we talk about, haan yaar, uska circuit kharab hai, no, what? Circuit baat karte hai. But we are now going to talk what is electric circuit. So dekho, electric circuit is nothing but like this. Theek hai, so this is just a diagram of electric circuit. So generally we have one cell, theek hai, and then we have a bulb, and we have ammeter, and we have a key. So first thing, any electric circuit is nothing but a closed and continuous path of what? Electric current. So dekho, tumhara whatever your home is, it's a circuit. Your laptop is a circuit. Your oven is a circuit. So any device which runs on electricity is having potentially what inside it? Electric circuit. So what it is? It's a continuous and closed path. It's a continuous, that means it doesn't end, and it's a closed path, that means it doesn't have opening. Okay, it is something like a circuit. So continuous and closed path for what? Electric current. It is called as electric circuit. So do one thing, write down this definition in your book. What is electric circuit? A continuous and closed path of electric current is called electric circuit. I will explain it more, but write down this definition. What is electric circuit? A continuous and closed path. So two keywords you have to remember. And this question is asked almost every year in the exam, that what is electric circuit? Closed and continuous path. Remember this. Okay, so write it down in your notebook. A closed and continuous path, or a continuous and closed path of electric current, is called as electric circuit. Okay, chalo. Now we will do one thing. We will understand what is electric circuit. Theek hai? So this is just a simple diagram. Theek hai, about electric circuits. So I will just mark it with notation that you can understand what those things are. Yes. So this, what you are looking at, this red box, is nothing but a battery. Battery means your regular battery, which you use in inverter. You must have seen even in cars. So these are battery. You can even attach cells, your battery cells, remote cells. Okay. Now these linings which you are seeing, okay, these lines are nothing but your, what I can say, electric wires. So we are connecting what? Your battery to whom? Your actual wires which you have at your home. So wires are connected to battery. And what is this? This particular thing, this I, this is nothing but flow of electrons. So this arrow is used to show electricity is flowing from where to where. So battery has how many terminals? Two terminals, positive and negative. So positive, negative we have, and electricity is flowing from positive to, you can see the direction. See, you can always see this direction. Where it is going? From positive to negative. Okay, so it is traveling from this direction and going towards the end section. Okay? Okay. Now there is another thing. I will just mark it with green color, this one. Okay? So this is the bulb. Okay, this is your regular electric bulb at your home. We call zero bulbs and all those kind of bulbs. So we have a battery. This is the current which is flowing. This is the bulb. And for now, I will just give you the name for this device, but it's working. We won't see right now. This is called as ammeter. Okay, so we have battery, we have electric current, we have bulb, regular bulbs, and this is ammeter, a device. We will see what it does afterwards. But for right now, we will just say that it's a ammeter. And the last but one the device which is present in this particular thing, which is marked as green, another green. So that is key. Okay, it is also called as plug key. In short, it can also be called as switch. The switch you have right at home to switch on or off any device. So this K is nothing but a plug key. Okay, so for today, remember this, that all these things make a normal electric circuit. So you can see what was the definition of electric circuit? Closed and continuous path, right? Closed. So please answer me this. Is it closed? This particular circuit is closed or not? I will just mark it. See. Okay. So just see whether it is continuous or not. It starts here. ठीक है, goes from that bulb, goes to the emitter, goes to the plug key, and again ends where? Again at the same battery. So that means it is a closed circuit and continuous. So continuous and closed circuit. So that is nothing but called as electric circuit. ठीक है, the continuous and closed path. So चलो, this is the diagram for your simple electric circuit. So do one thing, write this down, like particular this particular diagram, draw this in your notebook. And we will end our session for today here. ठीक है? So just draw this diagram. We'll just give you 1 minute, and we will sum up all the things which you have learned today. ठीक है? So give the heading as electric circuit diagram. Electric circuit diagram. And mention that those lines you can draw. You can use scale for this diagram. ठीक है? Do not draw these kind of diagrams without scale. You have to use scales. And draw it properly in your notebook, because ultimately these books are going to be used for your internal marks. 20 marks are there for your notebook. ठीक है, so please do it. Draw it properly. Okay, so we have a battery, this current, then we are having the bulb, and then we have emitter, right? And then the plug key, and then the battery again. Okay, I hope everybody has drawn it. Now what I will do is I will just give you some a quick advice on how to deal with science, fine? Okay. See students, in actual this particular subject science, many students do not get out of marks. That's a reality, and the reason being is that students do not pay much attention to this subject because their attention is given to maths. So understand this, this subject is not easy to crack. If you want to get 100 out of 100, you have to complete every concept, understand every question, understand its answer. If you have some doubts, you can always have to ask your teacher or to ask lot of help from your teacher. So make sure that you have a proper communication with whoever is teaching you any subject, not just science, maths also, SST also. There should be a strong connection between you and your teacher. Only then he'll be able to help you, he or she. Okay. Now how to deal with this particularly science subject? So all the questions which will be asked in the final exam will be from textbook itself, NCERT. So you have to complete word by word from NCERT. Only then you can expect that you will get 100 out of 100. So you cannot skip any line, you cannot skip any question. You have the habit of skipping many questions, okay, from homework point of view. But henceforth, you have to make sure that all the things which you are supposed, let us say, studying in this particular book, you do not skip it. Yes. Understand everything. If you have certain doubts, you can always ask. That is never a problem. And also do one thing. Issue is that whenever the things which will be completed, suppose let us say these concepts, complete it on that day itself. Because if you keep piling it up, what will happen is every time I'll be teaching you new concept, and when there will be, suppose let's say, you have to complete all the concepts at the same time, there will be a lot of confusion, you will get jumbled, and whenever you won't even get time to ask me, sir, this doubts and all. So complete the concepts on the same day itself. Okay, I will give you lots of instructions regarding this subject, but not right now. Today I have given you info about what kind of syllabus we have. How many exams we have? Five exams in total. And the last exam is going to be conducted in the month of December and January. P-board 1, December 1, December and January, P-board 2. And what kind of syllabus we have right now? That is 25% syllabus, three chapters, right? Chemical reaction, light processes and electricity. And our lesson will be electricity. So chalo, that's it for the day. We won't be starting much. We won't be completing much of these today. But what we'll be doing is, we'll be just completing just today's info, that's it. Nothing more we'll be completing, because what is going to happen is that if we try to complete many topics today, the time won't be permitting and it will just be what I can say, wastage of time. So we'll be meeting in the next session. Thank you for today. The timetable will be uploaded soon. Take care. Chalo. Thank you. Bye-bye.